Whew, now that's unsettling.
Like, wow. I'm sure glad we don't look like that.
See, Wayne, aren't you glad one of us grown-ups stand out here to protect you? Yeah. Creepy old park, killer clown on the loose. I'm clearly doing the right thing. You understand. It's not as though I'm hiding from anything or shirking responsibility, letting my friends walk into harm's way without my help. Let's say, for sake of argument, Wayne, that you are correct, that I merely used hanging back to protect you as a ploy to avoid entering the funhouse and inevitably confronting my fear of clowns. Even so, what do I have to prove by joining in? I'm sure the rest of the gang has things well in hand. Likes clowns anyway. The first time I encountered one, I was about your age. White skin, red lips, polka dot jumpsuit. Couldn't sleep for weeks. You know, Wayne, you're a really good listener. Funny people do nothing in the face of evil funny people, Wayne, then evil funny people win. And I, Velma Dinkley, am the unfunniest of them all. It's time, Wayne. I'm going in, huh?
Wow! Velma saved us.
You did it! You caught this fiend clown!
Actually, this clown is really... this clown.
Oopsie?
Oopsie?
Yes, Oopsie the clown. The motive is...
Oh, for crying out loud! It's really obvious what happened! Duh! I mean, any fool could see the motive. Looney Park was Oopsie's dream job, but Oopsie learned his boss, Lars Harmon, wanted to sell the boardwalk rather than sink money into a massive renovation. I mean, Oopsie knew everyone would stay out of the funhouse due to the legend of Madcap, as well as its dilapidated state. He used it as his base of operations to moonlight as Madcap. He hoped to scare off developers by making the legend of Madcap a reality. Blabbity blah. It was also obvious to everyone except these five dopes. Madcap was trained in the clowning arts. Physicality and acrobatics that Madcap displayed couldn't have been accomplished by a layman. But true to his lame name, Oopsie's lame plan backfired, driving the price of the already struggling operation even lower, motivating an already nervous Harmon to cut his losses and sell before he lost his shirt. Then that real estate lady, Clarabelle, seized the moment, sealed the deal just earlier tonight. Psh, drop mic.
Gee, thanks a lot.
I said Oopsie. And I would have gotten away with it, too. Hilariously, I might add, if it wasn't for you meddling kids.
Enough blather. Officers, take him away.
I'm not exactly sure what to charge him with, Mr. Harmon. He's a clown dressed as another clown.
But he's a scary bad clown.
All clowns are scary and bad. I think that's firmly established by this time.
The lady has a point. I got the willies just looking at him.
Oh, no! The clown police!
Oopsie the clown, you're under arrest for several violations of the Sacred Cardinal Code of Clowndom. You have the right to remain silent should you choose to be tried as a mime.
What just happened?